Hi guys. Okay, this is step two of the ultimate portion fix, kind of the next level of changing your lifestyle. So, and you're more than welcome to just go to that first level. It took a while for me to get there because I was so far gone before I started, just, you know, fast food and didn't really know nutrition. So I am going to talk about how I meal prep and plan my meals now, rather than buying vinaigrette at the store like I was talking about, or canned chicken, or the really fast, simple things. I like to have those around if I'm in a pinch so that I'm not getting fast food, which I don't ever anymore. And that was just a choice. That was like, okay, I'm not that person anymore. That's not my identity. I don't ever do that. Even if I get something for the kids, I don't ever buy anything, even if it's a salad, I just don't do it. My fast food is Starbucks and I get there, like it has the two eggs and it has the peanut butter and fruit, or I'll get, what do they have there? The turkey bacon and egg white sandwich with the whole grain, something like that. That is Dave and I both, that's our fast food and that's just who we decided to be. And I love it, it's changed our life. Okay. That being said, I will still plan crock pot meals. We do a lot of crock pot like pork or chicken. And like I said before, those are really easy to find all over the place. And they're really easy to plan out too. So I plan usually three of those, maybe two a week, and we'll have leftovers with those. And it's so easy and simple. And I always have turkey slices too, but I will hard boil eggs. I don't usually do the deviled eggs anymore, but when I started, I did because I loved them. And they are still, everything that I said before is still a great option too. This is just that next level. So cut veggies, you can make soup on Sunday and just have that, put it in containers for the week. Make chicken, put a little bit of spices on those. You can make turkey meatballs. I found a great turkey meatball recipe that I like. I use sweet potatoes instead of like regular potatoes. We still will have regular potatoes every once in a while too. And let's see, like I talked about the whole grain bread. I don't eat very much of that, but I might have some toast. And I make my dressing now, and I found those recipes in the Fix 8 cookbook. Those are the ones. And then the reset, which I'm doing now. And you can even, let's see, roast veggies even, and have those and just reheat them, have them in the fridge and reheat them. You can plan out your meals where you cook that chicken and you have the roasted veggies, you know, and you have cut up avocado or whatever. If you put plastic right over up on the avocado, it will keep it fresh. So that's what we do to keep it fresh, and we'll cut that. And you can put them in little containers for every single day. That's what David's been doing this week. I don't do that because I don't have to take stuff to go to work, but of course I do if I'm traveling or, you know, going to visit someone or something. I will plan it ahead of time. And you guys, the last thing I want to say, in the rice cooker. I make oatmeal and the kids love it in the rice cooker, and we make brown rice also in the rice cooker. David's been using a lot of like curry paste, and we make like stir fry veggies a lot. I don't usually make those on Sunday. We'll make those fresh. I roast veggies a lot too, because it doesn't take very long, I've realized. It's more the cutting. And if you can do some of that on Sunday, easy peasy, like super easy. I think that's about it. I can't remember what I was just saying. Healthy desserts too, I think are really great. I have to be careful with healthy desserts because I literally like want to eat them all in one sitting. So freezing them always helps that too. And then I always make sure that I have like Greek yogurt, a lot of it because the kids love it too, with frozen blueberries and just a little bit of honey is one of my favorite snacks. And you can put like a little bit of chocolate chips on there just to have a sweet treat. I really like that. It kind of replaced ice cream for me. And it takes a little bit of time. It's not like, oh, you know, go have your ice cream when you need it. Like that's the thing, is don't deprive yourself of what you want. But the second that you have it, you enjoy it and you say, okay, I'm back to like, that was really great. Now I'm going to continue on with my healthy lifestyle. So making that choice and committing to it. But that's just the next level, is making more of your food, because that other stuff is great in a pinch and it is way better than getting fast food, but it has preservatives. It's not the best for your body. It's not the most nutritious stuff that you can have for your body. This fresh fruits and veggies and cutting that up and having roasted veggies and having brown rice that you made at home in your rice cooker or oatmeal that you made at home is way more nutritious for you. I will say though, the oatmeal, if you get steel cut oats, as long as it's just oatmeal, you're good to go. You know, it's the pre-packaged stuff that you want to steer clear of. But that was kind of my first step, was it was too overwhelming to go all in and just roast veggies and make hard-boiled eggs and make chicken every Sunday. But so that was kind of my step slowly into it. And now I'm into it more and I realize that I have it in my head. I know the containers and I know what foods I love in there and I know what I want to have, that it doesn't take much planning at all. Now I just know, I kind of have even the food list in my head when I go to the grocery store. Okay, we need yogurt because we're running out of yogurt. The things that we just always have, turkey slices, the things that make it easy, but then I'm choosing to take a little extra time on Sunday and meal plan and meal prep my food, and cutting up cutting the veggies and fruit and that kind of stuff. So hopefully that helps you guys, like it helped me. And of course, water, 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 lots of water. Our bodies are, 90% water or something. So that if you're not feeling well, you have a headache, that's always my first thing. Even if you're feeling hungry, like, am I hungry or am I thirsty? A lot of time you're thirsty. So I'm really getting to know your body and listening to it and feeding it healthy, nutritious food. Okay. Bye, you guys.